If iOS 11 is known for various bugs and crashes, iOS 12 is going to be known for stability and performance improvements. There are many reasons to upgrade to iOS 12. We are just a couple of days away from iOS 12 Beta 1, and freshness is in the air. Hey, what's up everyone, Rahul here from techreport.com, and I have got a big news for you today. Apple's annual Worldwide Developer Conference WWDC 2018 is shaping up as expected, and we are going to get our hands on all new iOS 12 Beta 1 in just a few hours. If you are interested in iOS 12 Developer Beta 1 and waiting eagerly to get your hands on it, this video is for you, because there are a few certain things you need to know before installing iOS 12 Developer Beta 1. So I thought it's a better idea to put together all the information in a single video. So here we go guys, iOS 12 Beta 1, everything you need to know. Every year, Apple organizes its Worldwide Developers Conference, where developers meet from all around the globe and Apple unveils its upcoming software, whether that is upcoming iOS version, upcoming watchOS, Apple TV OS or macOS. And now Apple has two more devices to deal with, AirPods and HomePods. Well, fingers crossed, but who knows, Apple might unveil new software for these as well. Within just a few hours of WWDC event, Apple pushes new iOS developer beta, and people go crazy to download the beta software and then end up complaining about bugs and crashes. If you are interested in iOS 12 Beta 1, let me tell you, you should not be so excited to install it on the first day. The developer beta is not meant for everyone, and most of the times, these contain many bugs. So even if you are excited about iOS 12 Beta 1, I won't recommend you to download it on your primary phone. If you have a secondary phone where you want to test it, then go and download iOS 12 Beta 1. But if this is your primary phone, download it at your own risk, because iOS 12 Beta 1 might contain bugs, crashes and instability. You might end up charging your phone multiple times a day. This happens because most of your apps are not yet optimized for iOS 12 Beta 1. It may take time for developers to make their apps compatible with new iOS 12, and that's the reason why you might experience app crashes and battery draining. That being said, if you are interested in iOS 12 Beta 1, there are a few security measures you might want to ensure. Before you jump to download and install iOS 12 Beta 1, consider taking a backup of your iPhone either in iCloud or using iTunes on your Mac or PC. Taking backup is crucial because if something goes wrong, and you want to revert back to iOS 11.4, having a backup will come handy to downgrade from iOS 12 Beta 1 to iOS 11.4 without losing your data. The second thing I want to warn you is that consider downloading the beta profile from trusted Apple's developer website only. Although there are two ways you can install iOS 12 beta profile, one from Apple's official developer program while other being other third-party sources. While other third-party sources are cheap, but they might steal your personal sensitive information and your Apple ID might be at risk. So better idea would be to enroll in Apple's developer program and download the secure and trusted beta profile. Now that you have got all the required information before iOS 12 Beta 1, let's jump into our wish list of iOS 12 Beta 1 features. As Apple has previously hinted that life will be easier on iOS 12, so iOS 12 might not be a major update like iOS 7 or iOS 11. It is more likely that iOS 12 will bring stability, bug fixes and performance improvement, but that doesn't mean we can't expect some major features in iOS 12. Apple has a track record of surprising everyone, and WWDC 2018 and iOS 12 might be another opportunity to do so. With that being said, let's see some iOS 12 features wishlist. These are the iOS 12 features I want in the upcoming version of iOS. Over the last 10 years, more or less, the home screen layout on iOS has remained the same. It's not that I don't like the current layout of home screen, but if Apple revamps its design a bit, that would be interesting. It'll provide more space for clean and minimalist wallpapers. Believe it or not, the notifications on iOS 11 are a disaster. You will end up clearing them one by one for hours. If you clear them all at once, you will lose important notifications as well, which otherwise you don't want to miss. If you have got some leisure hours, go for clearing notifications. I don't clear notifications more often and you may see the endless scrolling. I desperately need a redesign for notification center, so that notifications can be grouped together either by app specific or even category specific like personal, social, financial, etc. Many people would argue, but it's fact that iOS has been optimized more for wireless data users than cellular data users. If you are on cellular data, you can't download or update any app having size more than 150 MB from App Store. If I'm traveling outside where there is no wireless network, I use my cellular data to download apps, but unfortunately I can't because of this limit. If you want to update your iPhone or iPad to the next iOS version, you need a Wi-Fi connection. You can't download and install updates on the cellular data network. I live in a small town in India where I don't have access to high-speed wireless network. I rely on cellular data and I need to create personal hotspot on another phone so that I may connect to that cellular network as Wi-Fi network. This does the job, but often it's irritating. Dear Apple, if anyone from Apple is watching this, please remove this restriction in iOS 12. We need this badly. At the same time, when competitors like Inbox by Gmail is getting smarter with artificial intelligence and Google Assistant integration, believe it or not, mail app is becoming a bit boring. Although Siri lags behind Google Assistant and I desperately want Siri to become as efficient as Google Assistant, yet artificial intelligence is not the only area where Apple's mail app lags. While Inbox by Gmail is a bit more colorful, mail app looks boring with less color. Apart from this, the mail app needs Wi-Fi to auto-refresh and fetch new emails quickly. With iOS 12, I want the mail app to become efficient enough to quickly fetch new emails even if connected to cellular data. So this was everything you needed to know about iOS 12 Beta 1. Obviously, there are many more wishes from iOS 12 Beta 1 like Smarter Siri, a concept of universal apps that can provide same user experience on the iOS device as well as Mac, and many more. Because when it comes to Apple, expectations are always high. But I can hardly believe Apple would bring all my wishlist of features on iOS anytime soon. Well, fingers crossed, who knows, Apple might surprise us again.
If you enjoyed watching this video, please hit that like button and share with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Tech Repro channel and tap on the bell icon, because I'll be bringing more or less every iOS 12 update exclusively for you. Thanks for watching. This is Rahul signing off. I'll see you in the next video.